Hello for Wednesday, April 8th. Two more trading days left in the week, and it wasn't too interesting in the markets, actually. The market, here's the Dow, this 15-minute chart, and of course it did pull back, but we said yesterday that it wasn't a very great setup for actually longs or shorts, because even if you went long on like this little breakout, right away there's resistance a couple levels up, and going short was, it turns out, a gap, so that wasn't good. And then we had all these supports close. Look, here we had this first dotted line, and then right below it we have the 200 period. Then below that we've got another line. You can see over here this was resistance, and then it broke through. That would mean it would become support, and that's about where it bounced, right about in that area, and plus this little trend line. So in my opinion, it wasn't a great trade. Now, there wasn't a good trade setup. If it does drop down to this trend line again, there is a place to watch for a possible buy or a short on a breakdown, because there you have a definite place where you'd know to cover your position one way or the other. But we'll see what happens on the upside. At the moment, it's also not a great setup, but you could draw a line here, which is now going to be resistance, across, which is resistance here and here, and maybe play a breakout here. We haven't drawn this, but you can do that on your own chart. So since the 15-minute charts weren't looking too good, we went back to a 60-minute chart, which we like to refer to, as you know. And here we've got from the March 9th low up to the recent top. And if we continue this pullback, obviously that we first got this trend line here, which had one, two, almost three touches. And basically that's sitting right now just about at the 200-day or 200-period EMA, which is 75.88. So that is a possibility if it breaks through this. Now you can see this red line here is a bit of support, so maybe that'll hold. But if it breaks through here, that's one point. And then below that is just, we're showing the Fibonacci's at 74.59 and then down at 72.80. That's a 50% retrace, which is not unlikely. Notice how it lines up right here. So if we do get a pickup and pullback, that wouldn't be bad to retrace 50% of this big move and then get ready to go again, we hope. Okay, here on the SPX, this is only a 15-minute chart. Once again, it came down right about to this gap, and that's where it then had a little bit of a bounce. It wasn't also a great setup, and I don't think it's a great setup here either. If it pulls back a little bit, it's got a little bit of support here and again over here, but it could be, I suppose, shorted down to this trend line. Now realize this trend line goes back quite a ways. That's why it cuts through both of these. I think it may still be a valid one. You can't always tell for sure when you've had a couple penetrations of it, but over here, anyway, there's one to watch there. And we just don't like the setup of that chart. And Russell, likewise. Now the Russell, we've been, of course, as we usually do, yak about this one because we know it pretty well, and that when you see a gap up and then a very thin pole up here, and the pole continues up here, it can't hold the weight. I mean, it's like, if you stick a little straw in the ground and it's going to fall over if you add all this weight over here. So we knew it's going to pull back. I mean, it's like it always happens. I've never seen an open case. So sure enough, we just never know when. But of course, it did pull back, and it was a good short. Obviously, if you short even a while back, if you can do that overnight, because here we've shown this negative divergence going on for a long time. And right here is when we had the RSI drop below 70, was here, and it moved up one day higher, but RSA dropped. That was a syndication that we got negative divergence here. And of course, from the high, it's dropped down pretty well. Anyway, down on the day about $15 in change. If you do trade the futures, that's $1,500. For every $500, that is if you got the full thing. But if you'd like to try futures, we've got a link on the homepage, Global Futures. It's only $500 margin that you have to put up per contract, sometimes even less. And anyway, they can set you up with real streaming data. It's live data, and try out the platforms and see if you like it. It's free of charge. So here anyway, we're looking for a possibility down here, and I think we do have a 60-minute chart also on the Russell. You can, just to show what the Fibonacci's would be, you can see it still has some support if it fills this gap, which is right about 430. So it could come down just a little bit more. Its low is 431.69, so down to 430 could bounce. That's basically filling the gap. Below that is 420 at the 200 period, and then we've got the Fibonacci right here, and then the 399 is a 50% retrace, which also has support over here. So if we happen to get a real strong pullback, look for that 399 as a possible bounce point in a place to go long. okay, we didn't have much action at all. We had a few things that moved higher, but most everything just moved lower. And some breakouts we took off the list, which is fine. If we have too many on the list, two things are going to happen. We did like a week or two ago. And so many on the list, we knew something's going to happen. Either we're going to have a big move one way or the other, and sure enough, then we get 10 per day breaking out. So one thing, they're either the ball going to collapse or they're going to start moving. Anyway, so a lot of people like to trade what we call this ninja trader system, because a lot of ninja platform is an automatic system where you can set the stocks to buy and sell, and you can go away and not have to look at them. And of course, this triggered at 41.80 at this crossover, and it closed up $3.20 above that. So a lot of people in the chat room are trading that. That was a nice $3 gain on the day, and it was automatic. You didn't have to think about it. Okay, additions to the watch list. We've got first the this is the ProShares Alter Financials. Look at the volume. The volume's been dropping off as it's pulled back towards this trend line. It ran into resistance at the 200-day or 50-day EMA and pulled back. It's still above this trend line. Nice trading channel. Now, these can collapse, of course, but if they move up, then they have good chance of continuing quite a bit if the volume increases. Anyway, we're putting on UYG. It's an ETF above $3.10. Just be aware, it's not a stock of its own. We've got DDR, similar kind of layout as the other. This trend line isn't actual because there's only a couple of touches here, but still fairly valid. We think a move over 277, but look, 293, 294 is a 50-day, but still over 277, but really, we need volume, and if that comes in, then this may be turn out to be a good trade. If it collapses, well, we're not in the trade at the moment, so that's okay. PCZ, look at that, good volume as it gapped up, and then again as it moved up after a pullback, and now it's got yet another island it deals with. Sometimes these islands can collapse, but sometimes they can hold up fine, and since it had okay volume and hasn't moved much, let's watch it. It's running into the 200-day, has some problems there, so if it can move above it, that would be above 30. Here's 3077, be aware of that. But above 30 on good volume, that one may be a move. Now, WGOV, another one of these that has a long red candle on the left, it's moved into that territory. This isn't exactly a breakout. It would have been at this 1243. But we still think that this is a possibility if we get a turnaround in stocks again in another few days or even a week. Because this is still hasn't collapsed with a lot of volume. So let's just watch this and see if it can move again over about that 1288 up to then maybe about the 14, maybe a trade. Now, OEH is not a fantastic one, but it improved later in the day. It was dropping off, but we kind of liked it, and volume did pick up later in the day too. That's good. But we just kind of like it when they're fooling around this 50-day, because the market changes, these things can move up. And also we can watch this. If it pulls back here and can hold it, some dip buyers might like to buy in there. Anyway, over $5.41 on OEH, and just a couple more here. Now this one also is an exact breakout because it technically already has, but again, we kind of like the fact that it's got this draw up here. This 200-day EMA is at 38.68. It's kind of like, you've gone so far, pretty good volume, you've got to reach it. Well, that's a dollar trade. That's worth taking the trade, I think. If the volume was in, market looks pretty good, then we'd say over 37.52, maybe a trade at least for the buck up to the 38.68. Then we've got CGX over 15.26. That also firmly puts it over the 50-day EMA. Also, we need higher volume on that. But again, this is one of these. A lot of them have run in the 50-day. If we can get another run in the market, which we do expect we will have, but we just don't know how long it's going to take the pullback, but maybe some earnings surprises will come out and spark everyone. Anyway, 15.26, some of these early, we think this is a possibility. And what are we? I think we're going to mention a couple, just one other thing, and that is only that why are we mentioning even? Oh, this is our default chart. In other words, we bookmark a chart that has our settings that we use, and then we just click on the bookmark and this chart opens. So I see this chart many, many, many times a day, and just notice it did try a breakout. I was going to put it on the list yesterday, I didn't, but FCSX, it did move pretty good intraday and then pulled back. I'm not putting it on the list, but if you'd like to look at it. So that's what we got for Wednesday. We want to thank you for coming by the site. We hope you have a great trading day today, and we'll be back again tomorrow with some new ideas. Thanks a lot. Bye-bye.